Hello viewers, my name is Ruth Olawoyin, creative director of Ribbons'n'Stitches. So I welcome you to another video. Today we'll be taking body measurements. As you know that to get a perfect fit of any garment, the measurements must be taken accurately. So we want to demonstrate how to take body measurements. So we are starting with the three important measurements that are used to determine your size in case you are going for a ready to wear. That's the bust, waist and hip. Okay, so to take the bust measurement, you pass your tape over the fullest part of the bust and you make sure that your tape is not going down at the back. Yeah, don't even take it this way. No, that's not the right measure. Make sure it's going parallel, just round the fullest part of the bust. Make sure it's not going down. Then the waist, that take it at the true waist. You can ask the clients to bend inwards so that you see where the curve actually is on the waist. That's some inches above the navel this way. Okay, so this is the waist measurement. So the hip, now also pass your tape measure around the fullest part of the hip. Be sure that it's the fullest part of the hip. That's why we are going over it this way. So this is 38 as the hip measurement. Then for those that do freehand, you can also apply sometimes in pattern drafts. You can take the half length, that's from the shoulder to the waist, to the true waist. Yeah, if you are going for a blouse, you can take the blouse, the length of the blouse. If it's a dress, you can take the knee level, the floor length and all of that. Then if you are doing a contoured garment, you will need the bust point, that's the highest point on the bust. You will need the under bust. You will need the bust span or bust separation. Then you also need your chest measurement when you are drafting pattern. Just where the arm joins with the body, the chest measurement. So I think we are done with the front, so we can go to the back. So for the back, you need your shoulder to shoulder measurement. So there is a bone here that you feel where this hand is joining the shoulder. So you take from there to the other shoulder. That's the back measurement. Then we have across back, especially if you are drafting patterns using the Natalie Bay method, you need across back. That's from here, that's where the armpit is joins the body, to from one side to the other. Then you need length to waist, that is from the bone here down to where the waist goes in. That's the length to waist. Then for sleeve measurements, depending on the length of the sleeve you want. If you are going for a long sleeve, the client has to bend the arm so that you get the true length. So you start from the shoulder here over the bent arm to the wrist for a long sleeve. For a three-quarter, depending on what you want, can be somewhere around here. I think for a half sleeve to the just above the elbow for a short sleeve. And make sure you take the sleeve round for each of the lengths too. Sleeve round with ease, with just a little ease, something like this for all the lengths that you are taking for the arm. So then also you need the shoulder, that is from the nape of the neck to the shoulder. Yeah, that is shoulder measurement. So I think this should suffice for now. So I think everybody should try and go over this measurement. You can try for yourself, try for your friend and see how the result looks like. So we'll meet in another video. Thank you.
Bye.